action of an electron pair donor with an electron pair acceptor. An sp3 hybridized electrophile must have a leaving group in order for the reaction to take place. The term SN2 means that two molecules are involved in the actual transition state. The departure of the leaving group occurs simultaneously with the backside attack by the nucleophile. The SN2 reaction thus leads to a predictable configuration of the stereocenter. It proceeds with inversion. In the SN1 reaction, a planar...
Okay, now hold up. This doesn't make any sense. Could someone please try to explain this better?
I will. Stepwise process. Stepwise process. All right, leave. Now rearrange and attack. The nuke will come from the front or the back. Stability is a determining factor. That's what the carbon count ion is for. How many steps, yo? I don't know. Depends on the type of the reagent, though. Before the attack, the proton could transport. But if it needs, it can transfer after.
Wait, no. SN2 is so much easier. Here, let me show you. When you see that prime substrate, backside attack. Can you comprehend?
Sounds dark, McGinnis! Rap battle! Yeah! To the dead! Yeah!
No, not again.
They'd be like, oh, what? Can you teach me how to SN1? You know why? Cause it is so much fun. All you need is a tertiary substrate, cause a methyl and primary are uncertain. The first step could be one of two things. When the leaving group ain't good, we need that proton, right? But if it's fine, then we can kiss that leaving group goodbye. It's really simple, cause it's unimolecular. The very next thing is an intermediate. And if it's unstable, we need a rearrangement. Now that we've learned it, so we can do it all day. Teach me how to open.
Teach me how to. Oh. Oh yeah. So concerted process in one hop. The reactants do a swap. Steric hindrance makes it stop. And protoxolvents hit the spot.
The nuke comes through.
And vertex box brand new.
SN2.
Is that all you got?
Raise and mix products is what you're gonna get. Polar proton solvents, reagents, plus. Let me hear y'all say those steps. I wanna know y'all know those steps. Everybody say those steps. This is SN1.
Okay, stop. I'm about to shut it down. Let's go. Yeah, everybody in the classroom right now. If your heads are down, you need to wake up. Get up, because when we do SN2 reactions, we don't need no rearrangements. No rearrangements. Let's do some O-chem. SN2 reactions. SN2 reactions. SN2 reactions, no rearrangement, SN2 reactions.
An SN1 mechanism is a stepwise process. First, the leaving group leaves, as we see here. A leaving group is a group capable of separating from a compound. This creates a carbocation, as we see here. A carbocation is an intermediate containing a positively charged carbon atom. The nucleophile attacks this positively charged carbocation. A nucleophile is a compound containing an electron-rich atom that is capable of donating an electron pair. The SN1 mechanism results in a racemic mixture due to the carbocation. This can be attacked from either side, which explains the racemic mixture. This process prefers polar protic solution, which is a solution that contains hydrogen bonds. Over here, we have an SN2 process, which is a concerted process, meaning that the reactions that we see here happen at the same time. The strong nucleophile donates electrons to the primary carbon, while the carbon donates electrons to the leaving group. This results in an inverted product because we don't have a racemic mixture because we do not have a carbocation. This mechanism prefers polar aprotic solution, which is a solution that does not contain hydrogen bonds.